Yes, baseball is back finally. Today, April 1st, opening day. And I thought, what better way to celebrate by dropping my MLB season predictions. This video took me a long time to make, so I'd appreciate it if you left a like on the video. Also, subscribe to the channel. We're trying to get to 50 subs, and we can't do that without you subscribing, so click that subscribe button. Without further ado, let's begin. We're going to start off in the AL East, and in first place, I obviously have the New York Yankees. I can't see anybody else taking that division but the New York Yankees. They just have such a loaded lineup, and they've been the dominant team in that division for decades. They have Judge, Stanton, Voit, Urshela, they have Gleyber Torres, they have Gary Sanchez. 1-9 is absolutely insane. They are the American League Dodgers. The pitching, Garrett Cole, Corey Kluber, bullpen is amazing. You have Aroldis Chapman and Chad Green. Now, losing J.A. Happ and Masahiro Tanaka is going to hurt them, but they're the New York Yankees. They're going to win anyways, so they're my first place team. Coming in second place, I don't know why so many people are down on them. The Tampa Bay Rays. I know they lost Blake Snell, but they were so good in 2019 and 2020, making the World Series in 2020. And they are just an absolute insanely good team on paper. Their pitching is good. They have Tyler Glasnow, like I said. Their bullpen's pretty decent, and their lineup is just amazing. They have Randy Arozarena, who is just going to have, he might have an MVP season this year. And the Rays, they're just too good of a team not to be second place. Moving on to third place, the Toronto Blue Jays. Wow, the Blue Jays had quite an offseason. George Springer, Marcus Semien, Kirby Yates, Tyler Chatwood. They added a bunch of good players, along with Hyunjin Ryu as their ace, and the young talented core that they have of Lourdes Gurriel Jr., Vladimir Guerrero Jr. They have Kevin Biggio and Bo Bichette. They just have such a good team. You cannot put them in third place. Like, it's just, they have too good of a team. Coming in fourth place, the Boston Red Sox. The Red Sox have just let everybody go. Mookie Betts, David Price, Andrew Benintendi. I'm forgetting someone. Their entire team has been gone. Like, they just traded everybody. They let everybody go. Chris Sale, he's a big question mark right now. His career might even be over. Your best pitcher is Nathan Eovaldi, and it's just, the offense is pretty good. Xander Bogaerts, Rafael Devers, Hunter Renfroe, Kevin Pillar. That's a pretty good lineup, but the AL East is just a too strong of a division. And obviously, fifth place, Baltimore Orioles. I'll keep it short and sweet. The Orioles are not a good team, but I don't think they'll be as bad as they have been in years past. They do have some talented young players, and with Trey Mancini coming back, that's going to help them out a lot. So fifth place, Baltimore Orioles. Moving on to the AL Central, I have the Minnesota Twins coming in first place. Just the Twins, they're like the Yankees. They are unstoppable. Just look at their lineup. Nelson Cruz, who is 42 years old and one of the best hitters in the entire league. Josh Donaldson, Byron Buxton, Jorge Polanco. They are just so good of a team. They have Max Kepler. They are an insanely good team. And then pitching's pretty good. Kenta Maeda and Jose Barrios, two really good pitchers. Bullpen is a little kind of iffy right now. Losing Jake Odorizzi is going to hurt them, but they're just too good not to be first place. Coming in second place, I have the Chicago White Sox. The White Sox, the surprise team of 2020, they were absolutely on fire, and I just think they will be again. They had a pretty good offseason. They brought back Adam Eaton and signed Lance Lynn, so they have some pretty good pitching. Bullpen's pretty good, and then offense, just MVP award winner Jose Abreu. They have Luis Robert. Eloy Jimenez being out, it's going to impact them a little. That's why I don't have them in first place. But they still got Tim Anderson and Yasmani Grandal. Now, moving on to third place, I have the Kansas City Royals. I don't know why. It just seems like the Royals are just going to have a really good year. They had a pretty good offseason. They added Carlos Santana and Andrew Benintendi, and then they added Mike Minor to help out that rotation because their rotation's kind of weak. The bullpen is kind of weak, but the offense is pretty good. They also have Montecia and Whit Merrifield at shortstop and second base, and that's why I think they'll be the third place team. Coming behind, just three games behind the Royals, I have Cleveland. Cleveland has just lost everybody. They've lost Francisco Lindor, Carlos Carrasco, Mike Clevenger, Trevor Bauer, just so many players. And they're just not that team that they were in 2016, and they want to be a better team. They need to get that offense back up. They need to stop being so cheap, and they need to get some better pitching, because the pitching's still pretty good, but it's a little bit weak. Shane Bieber is about their only pitcher now, and the bullpen is just horrendous. They need to fix that bullpen. Fifth place, Detroit Tigers. It's the Tigers. They're just not good anymore. They have some nice young players. Spencer Torkelson could be coming up soon, but one guy can't carry a team in baseball, and they just don't have a good team. So fifth place. First place in the AL West. I do not want to pick them, but I want to go with the safe bet, the Houston Astros. The Astros did not have the best year in 2020. I think the cheating scandal got to a lot of the players' heads, like Jose Altuve and Alex Bregman. Losing George Springer is not good for them, but they still got Michael Brantley, Alex Bregman. But they might be losing Carlos Correa and Jose Altuve. But they just have too good a lineup not to put them in first place. Moving on to second place, I have the Oakland A's. The A's, they are a pretty good team. I don't know why so many people are sleeping on them. They have such a good lineup. Chapman, Ramon Laureano, they have Matt Olson. And they do have some injuries. The starting pitching is pretty good. The bullpen is kind of okay, but they just play good enough baseball to be a good team. So, second place. Third place, I never thought I'd say this in a million years, Seattle Mariners. The Mariners have such a young core. J.P. Crawford, Kyle Lewis, Evan White. Three really good young players who have potential in the future. And then Justin Sheffield is a very good young pitcher. The bullpen, they have a lot of young arms. They're just a good young team, and that's why I think they'll be third place. Also, the AL West is one of the weaker divisions in all of baseball. Coming in fourth place, I do not want to put them in fourth place because I want to see Mike Trout be in the playoffs, and I think that gave it away. Angels. Fourth place, they have a good offense. Ohtani, Trout, Rendon, Fletcher. Such a good offense. But the pitching, your best pitcher is Dylan Bundy, and your best reliever is Rossy Iglesias. Nothing wrong for Rossy Iglesias. It's just you don't have pitching. And fifth place, Texas Rangers. They were super good in 2019, and then they just fell off the face of the earth in 2020. They traded a bunch of players away. They have a whole new team, and they're just not good anymore. So, fifth place. Moving on to the NL East. First place, Atlanta Braves. I know a lot of people want to pick the Mets, but I have the Braves. The Braves, they're just like the Yankees. They are too good. They have such a young, talented lineup with some good veterans. Freeman, Ozuna, Acuna, Albies, Swanson, Riley. They have very, very good. 1-9 is a very, very good lineup there. And then the rotation. Mike Soroka being out is going to hurt them, but they still have Charlie Morton and Max Fried. And then the bullpen's pretty good, so first place, Atlanta Braves. And that will be their eighth consecutive title in a row. The New York Mets will be the second place team. I know the Mets made so many good moves. Carlos Carrasco, Trevor May, and Francisco Lindor, and James McCann being the big four moves. But they just don't have it yet. They need to improve the bullpen a little bit more. The rotation is absolutely perfect. But they just need a bit more of a better offense because their outfield is kind of weak. So, second place, New York Mets. Coming in third place, I have the Washington Nationals. So many people are sleeping on the Nationals. I don't understand. I know they don't have Anthony Rendon anymore. Max Scherzer, I think he's going to have a bounce back year, but Steven Strasburg is kind of a question mark. But they still have Patrick Corbin, and then their lineup, absolutely insane. Juan Soto, Josh Bell, they have Kyle Schwarber, Trey Turner. They just have an amazing, amazing lineup. Plus, they just have so many young, talented players. But that bullpen, it's horrendous, and that's why they're third place. Fourth place, I have the fourth place Philadelphia Phillies, as Draft Nick Marks likes to say. The reason I think they're fourth place is the pitching. Your best pitcher is Aaron Nola. Nothing wrong with him. It's just one guy can't carry a rotation. And then the bullpen, sorry about the noise in the background. The bullpen is just horrendous. But offense is pretty good. You got Hoskins, Real Muto, Harper, and Gregorius. But you need better pitching if you want to be a good team. So, fourth place. And fifth place, Miami Marlins. I wanted to put them in fourth or third place so bad after the amazing 2020 year they had, but it's 162 game schedule now. We're not in the shortened season, so I don't think the Marlins will be as good. Moving on to the NL Central. St. Louis Cardinals come in first place by just a hair. They had to take the Rocky star baseman, Nolan Arenado, to add to that already amazing lineup of Paul DeJong and Harrison Bader and Paul Goldschmidt. And then pitching's pretty good. Bullpen needs a little bit of help, but they'll just play good enough baseball to be first place. And the NL Central is kind of getting weaker. Second place, just by 4 wins behind, I have the Milwaukee Brewers, the Brew Crew. Every time I look at them, they just seem to get better and better. They have Christian Yelich. They added Colton Wong. They have Lorenzo Cain. They have a pretty good offense. Pitching is amazing. Bullpen is amazing. They have Josh Hader and Brandon Woodruff as their ace. They're just a good team in general. So second place. Third place, Chicago Cubs. The Cubs, they are such a good team offensively. They have Baez, Rizzo, Bryant, Hayward, Contreras. I think I'm forgetting someone. They have such a good offense, but bullpen-wise, not that good. And their best pitcher is Kyle Hendricks. And like I said, with a lot of these teams, like the Phillies, one guy can't carry a rotation. And losing Yu Darvish is going to hurt them. Fourth place, Cincinnati Reds. They were supposed to be the surprise team in 2020, but they weren't. They were not the surprise team. And they just, on paper, they look so good. They have such a good lineup. And pitching is pretty good, even after losing Trevor Bauer. But they just don't seem to play good enough. So, fourth place. Fifth place, Pittsburgh Pirates, arguably the worst team in all of MLB. I'll just keep it short and sweet. Pirates need to improve. Go full rebuild mode. There. Now, moving on to the NL West. First place, the Los Angeles Dodgers. The Dodgers, they're just so good. 1-9, amazing. Muncy, Seager, Bellinger, Betts, Turner, Will Smith. They have AJ Pollock. 1-9 is amazing. And then pitching, 1-5 is amazing. Every bullpen spot is amazing. Their bench is so in-depth. Their bench is a playoff contender. They are just, the Dodgers are too good. They might win every single game this year. Now, San Diego Padres, they will be my second place team. They are also just super good. Tatis, Machado, they have Tommy Pham. They're Will Myers. They are just such a good team. And then that pitching, they made so many improvements. They added Mike Clevinger, Blake Snell, Yu Darvish, and Joe Musgrove. And now they have Chris Paddock, who had an amazing 2019 year. The Padres are so good. Second place. Third place, San Francisco Giants. On paper, they don't look good. They just have so many players from that dynasty from the early 2010s that are just old and they're not good anymore. Brandon Belt, Evan Longoria, Brandon Crawford, they're all washed. You need to get rid of them. Jeff Samardzija is their best pitcher. The bullpen's not good. Mike Yastrzemski, he's pretty much their best player, and they just seem to play just right enough. And third place, fourth place, a lot of people have them in last place. The Colorado Rockies. I don't know why, but the Colorado Rockies, I don't know why so many people are sleeping on them. We are still good even after losing Nolan Arenado and Trevor Story possibly walking out. And we lost David Dahl, Ian Desmond's not playing, but we're still good enough. We got McMahon, Story, Blackman, and we got Garrett Hampson. Pitching's still pretty good. Herman Marquez, Antonio Senzatella, and John Gray. And then bullpen needs a lot of help, but we're not a last place team. Fifth place, Arizona Diamondbacks, just not that good team anymore. They're not the 2019 Cells, and that's why I have them in fifth place. Before we move on to the playoffs, let's go over the awards. In the National League MVP, I have Juan Soto. Juan Soto, next coming of Ted Williams. We're watching one of the greatest players to ever live. He is just absolutely insane. He hits for a high average. He drives in runs, RBIs. I'm predicting he will win the Triple Crown. Not the National League Triple Crown, the MLB Triple Crown, which hasn't been done since Miguel Cabrera in 2014. So yeah, Juan Soto, my NL MVP. AL MVP. I wanted to pick Aaron Judge, but I don't know if he can stay healthy. So I went with the just safe, simple pick, Mike Trout. I'm just going to leave it at this. He's the GOAT. He's the GOAT. He is just insane. So that's why he's the AL MVP. NL Cy Young. As much as I want to pick Jacob DeGrom, I did not want to go with the boring pick. So I ended up going with Kyle Hendricks, But I went with Yu Darvish because back when the season started, the Cubs were the only team that were really on, and I saw Yu Darvish pitch two games, and he was insane. He has some nasty, nasty stuff. He threw a no-hitter until, like, the sixth inning, I think, and then threw 13 strikeouts in the next game or something like that. He's just an insane pitcher, and since the Cy Young usually goes to pitchers with a lot of wins, and the Padres are going to be good, Yu Darvish, Cy Young. AL Cy Young. As much as I want to go with Lucas Giolito or Garrett Cole, I pick Shane Bieber. Shane Bieber, he's just too good of a pitcher. He is just insane. He strikes out a lot of batters, and his ERA and the whip are super low, and that's what you want to see out of a pitcher, so he will be the AL Cy Young Award winner. Rookie of the Year, everybody has him as his National League Rookie of the Year, Ke'Bryan Hayes. In the short sample size that we got, he only played like 20 games last year, but he was insane. 280 batting average, 5 home runs, and defensively, he is amazing. Just Ke'Bryan Hayes, he is an amazing, amazing third baseman, and he's going to probably be the top 10 third, one of the top 10 third basemen, and all of them will be at the end of the season. So, Rookie of the Year. There are so many talented American League rookies right now, but Randy Arozarena, he's known for having the most home runs in a postseason ever. And he's just, he's so good. He's so talented. He burst onto the scene. Everybody loves the story of Randy Arozarena. Everybody loves Randy Arozarena. And I'm going to pick him as my AL Rookie of the Year. Moving on to the playoffs. In the National League Wild Card game, we have the Mets and the Cardinals matching up. I thought very, very hard. Two teams so similar. They're just like third and fourth, and they are both such good teams. But in a one-game series, I'm gonna have to give the edge to the New York Mets. That means in the division series, we'll have the Dodgers and the Mets, and obviously Dodgers move on. I just sat there a minute ago just talking about how good the Dodgers are, and there's no way the Mets are beating them. A matchup I'm excited for. The Braves and the Padres, two very, very young teams. It's going to come down to a Game 5, and I have the San Diego Padres moving on. That means to go into the World Series, the Padres and the Dodgers. The Dodgers are obviously moving on, but the Padres are going to bring it to a Game 6, maybe even a Game 7. They're not giving up without a fight, so Dodgers move on to the World Series. In the AL Wild Card, we have a rematch of the 2005 World Series. We had the White Sox and the Houston Astros. I don't want to pick the Astros, and I just think the White Sox will win that one-game series, so Chicago White Sox. That means in the division series, we will have the White Sox and the Yankees. I know this is going to shock a lot of you, but I'm going to have to give the edge to the Chicago White Sox. I don't know why my gut just says picks the White Sox. They are just too good of a team, so Chicago White Sox. Now, other division series, we have the Minnesota Twins and the Tampa Bay Rays. This is a tough, tough one. It's going to come down to a Game 5. And overall, I'm picking the Tampa Bay Rays. The Twins, as good as they are, they just don't seem to play well in the playoffs. So, Tampa Bay Rays. That means moving on to the World Series is either the Chicago White Sox or the Tampa Bay Rays. And this is a matchup I'm so excited for. And in a Game 6 victory, it's going to the Chicago White Sox. Meaning, in the World Series, coming down to an exciting Game 7 between the Dodgers and the White Sox, I have the, drumroll please, Chicago White Sox winning the World Series. That's right, Chicago White Sox will win the 2021 World Series. They are my 2021 World Series champions. Hope you enjoyed, and make sure to leave a like on the video and also subscribe to the channel. Hope you enjoyed, hope you have a good day, and I'll see you in another video. Until then, peace out.